What's up, y'all? It's Steve here, and we've got an update for you on one state that has passed a stimulus package and is likely going to be sending out a variety of stimulus checks. And this is your stimulus check update and stimulus package update. Now, first, let me know in the comments down below, yes on the hat or Stick around to the end. I'm going to give you a short story on the hat here. But you guys, take a look at these articles coming out like this. Governor Greg Abbott signs a bill allocating nearly $16 billion in pandemic stimulus bill funds. Here's another one that just came out today. Stimulus checks for Texans. Governor Abbott signed Senate Bill 8 allocating federal funding. And the article says these funds will be used for a variety of programs and could mean pandemic stimulus checks for Texans, y'all. Now, the reason why this is happening, as you know, is because in the last federal-level stimulus package signed into law back in March of 2021, there was $350 billion allocated to go out to states to use for their residents however they see fit. And seeing how Congress has not yet passed a fourth federal-level stimulus check, a lot of the governors are saying, well, we're going to use these stimulus provisions to send out more aid, more assistance, more checks to our residents. And if you missed the video I uploaded just before this one, take a look, you guys. 500,000 Americans are expecting to receive payments today worth $285 in one lucky state. They're sending out those stimulus checks. Also, take a look at this. A couple days ago, I let you know, Senate passes spending bill in one state, and that is Massachusetts, for essential workers that could receive up to $2,000 stimulus checks. These are rolling out. Here's another one I reported to you in another video just the other day. How many stimulus check payments remain in California? Well, 784,000 of them are going to be going out, and those are stimulus checks of $1,100 in some cases. So you guys, checks are rolling out left and right for states. I will keep you up to date. If y'all have not hit the subscribe button yet, you might want to do so, because we're hearing there's a lot of leftover funds that states still need to use for their residents. And also, check out that video right after this one, because today is the last day. If you missed your third federal level stimulus check, or you're missing child tax credits, November 15th, the Get CTC will be closing. So right after this video, go to that video clip that I did on this. It walks you step by step how to make sure that you get those checks, that the IRS knows exactly your updated information, and you don't have to wait till next year to claim it as a credit on your taxes. And also, you guys, right now, at the time of this recording, President Joe Biden is signing into law the infrastructure bill, which will be passing, and we're hearing that Congress is going to be working away on the next federal level stimulus reconciliation bill, and I will keep you guys up to date on all of that. But let's go ahead and dive right in. And first up, though, I want to say thank you guys so much for all the support on the second channel, Steve Ram Finance, over 500 new subscribers. Really excited about that channel. If you want to join and you want to subscribe, I will pin a comment down below. All you got to do is click the link and then click subscribe, and you'll be able to join if you're interested in building wealth or learning more about personal finance. I'm really excited about that channel. Thank you guys for all the support, but let's go ahead and dive right in and get y'all caught up on the stimulus package passing in the state of Texas as of today, November 15th, 2021. But before we do, if you could do me a quick favor, just takes a second, smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm. Helps me out a ton. Thank you so much. Leave your comments, share this out. If this is your first time here and you want to stay up to date, hit the subscribe button, turn on that notification bell. And if you got any specific questions that you want to ask me, I'm easy to get a hold of. All you got to do is shoot me a DM on Instagram at SteveRam3. Best way to get a hold of me. Here on YouTube, there's a ton of comments, and sometimes scammers go in the comments and they try to pretend that they're me, and they ask for your personal information and tell you to contact them on WhatsApp and trick you. And you guys, that's not me. Don't fall for it. If you got any specific questions, reach out to me on Instagram. But with that being said, you guys, let's go ahead and dive right in and get you caught up on the latest on the new stimulus in the Lone Star State. All right, you guys, so link in the description below to this article that came out. I always cite my sources, so that way you can read them for yourself and see that I'm not just making up random stuff. Now, the article says that Texas Governor Greg Abbott, he signed the Senate Bill 8 into law Tuesday, November the 8th. So about a week ago, he actually signed this into law, which will allocate nearly $16 billion in funding awarded to the state earlier this year through the Federal American Rescue Plan Act. And as we mentioned, that had $350 billion that went out to states, and now Texas They're taking their portion and they're going to be using it to give to their state residents. Now, that was also known as the stimulus package, or that American Rescue Plan that was signed by President Joe Biden back in March of 2021 to provide $1.9 trillion to help with public health and economic recovery. Now, that package, you will recall, it had included a third federal level stimulus check of $1,400. It also extended out the federal unemployment insurance benefits of PUA, PEUC, and that $300 per week boost. It also increased the child tax credit and the earned income tax credit, among many other provisions that helped out people with that package. Now, under the American Rescue Plan, the state of Texas received nearly $16 billion to help with the fiscal recovery, and now they're using it in this state stimulus package. And here's what Governor Greg Abbott had to say on this. Senate Bill 8 allocates federal funding to support Texans in need, including our veterans, rural communities, small businesses, and frontline workers. Allocating these federal funds paves the way for a more prosperous and brighter future for all Texans, and I want to thank my partners in the legislature for bringing this bill to my desk. Now, you guys, let's go ahead and cover what's included in this stimulus package, and keep in mind the fact that there's going to be funds distributed to all of these groups, and we're hearing that it's very likely a lot of them might receive some form of stimulus checks. Now, under this bill, various state resources and programs will receive funds, $7.2 billion to the Unemployment Compensation Fund to pay outstanding advances and to bring the balance of the fund to statutory floors, so $7.2 to unemployment, $500 million for broadband infrastructure, $150 million for the deployment of reliable operations of next-generation 911 services, $180 million for the recovery of tourism, travel, and hospitality industries that have not received federal aid, $160 million to address the Federal Victims of Crime Act, or VOCA, shortfall affecting crime victims assistance grants, $2 billion for state and local hospital surge staffing, antibody therapeutic drugs, and the operation of regional antibody infusion centers, $378 million for critical staffing needs of frontline workers, including recruitment and retention bonuses for nursing facilities, assisted living facilities, and emergency medical service providers. Sounds like checks are on the way there. $75 million to support rural hospitals affected by the pandemic, $113 million to support the operations and the expansions of mental health services for Texans' children and families, $35 million to upgrade all 9 Texas state veteran homes, along with the negative pressure of the pandemic wards and mobile high-efficiency particulate air, or HEPA, filtration units for homes, so HEPA to help fight against the pandemic, and $95 million for food banks in response to the pandemic. And listen to this note here at the very bottom. Upon the signing of the Senate Bill 8 into law, Governor Greg Abbott also filed a statement to clarify that this bill does not lead to the pandemic vaccine mandate in the Lone Star State. So you guys, that is the latest on the stimulus package passed into law in the state of Texas. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you might want to do so, because I'm expecting we're going to be hearing a whole lot more on state stimulus packages and checks coming out, as we're hearing that that $350 billion still hasn't even been touched by the majority of states. So you guys, I'll keep you up to date on that. And if you haven't already, don't forget, leave your comments on your thoughts on the hat. Here's the story on the hat. So as you guys know, we moved to Texas about 5 months ago from California, and when we got here, I was expecting to see a whole bunch of cowboys, and I haven't seen any. Nobody around here wears hats. As a matter of fact, this hat is probably the biggest giveaway that I'm not actually from Texas. I'm actually from California. And I asked my wife, I said, so should I get a cowboy hat? I mean, hey, we're in Texas. And she said, absolutely not. Do not get a hat. And if you do get one, do not wear it around me. Now, I told one of my friends, I was like, so I haven't gotten a hat yet because nobody wears them. And he told me, listen, women love the hats. Even if Monica says she doesn't like it, she actually will. So you should just go ahead and get the hat. Now, let me know your thoughts, ladies, in the comments down below. Do you think that the guys wearing a cowboy hat is a good look or not so much? So I was like, okay, like I took his advice. And I went and took the kids, we got some cowboy hats, and I came back and I showed Monica to try to see what she thought, and she said, still hates it. So let me know your thoughts, you guys. And where are the Cowboys at in Texas? Because they're definitely not in Houston. I'm guessing maybe they're in Dallas, or let me know down in the comments down below, you guys. But that is the story on the hat. And as we speak right now, President Joe Biden is signing into law the infrastructure bill. I'll be sure to keep you guys up to date on that. And we're hearing that Congress is going to be working away on the stimulus reconciliation bill this week and work out all the details. I will keep you up to date here on the channel, you guys. But that is the latest. Thank you so much for joining me. If you made it this far and you haven't already, don't forget, smash the like button. Helps out with the YouTube algorithm a ton. Thank you so much. Leave your comments on the hat. Share this out if you think it's going to help out other people. If this is your first time here and you want to stay up to date, hit the subscribe button. Turn on the notification bell. Join the second channel to learn about finance at Steve Ram Finance and Building Wealth. And if you got any specific questions for me, shoot them to me in the DM on Instagram at SteveRam3. But with that being said, you guys, hope this reaches you well. I will catch you in the next one. Take care. God bless. This is Steve.